What if I told you that age-related memory loss is actually a myth we tell ourselves? The truth is, your brain can be sharper at 60 than it was at 30. This isn't motivation. This is science. You've probably heard a joke like this at a family gathering. Oh, Dad's having another senior moment. Or maybe you've started to worry when you misplace your keys, thinking, is this the beginning of the end? For decades, we've just accepted the idea that getting older must mean becoming forgetful, thinking slower, and struggling to learn new things. This belief is so strong, it feels like an undeniable law of nature. But here's the most dangerous part. This belief works like a self-fulfilling prophecy. Imagine this. If a farmer is convinced his soil is barren, will he bother to till the land, add fertilizer, and water it every day? Of course not. And as a result, the soil truly becomes barren. Our brain is exactly the same. When we believe our minds will weaken, we stop giving them fertilizer and water. We stop trying to learn new things because, what's the point? I'm too old. We stop challenging ourselves with puzzles or complex discussions. We surrender. And it's because of that surrender that our brains truly lose their edge, not because of age, but because of neglect. So, what does modern science have to say? It offers a radically optimistic answer. The answer lies in one key word that will change the way you see aging forever: neuroplasticity. It sounds complex, but the concept is incredibly simple. Neuro means nerve, and plastic means moldable or flexible. So, neuroplasticity is the brain's amazing ability to keep changing, adapting, and forming new connections throughout our entire lives. The easiest way to understand it is to think of the brain as a muscle. If you consistently hit the gym and lift weights, your bicep gets bigger and stronger, right? But if you stop completely for a year, that muscle shrinks. The brain works exactly like that. Activities like learning a new language, trying a complex recipe, playing a musical instrument, or even just taking a different route home from work, that's all lifting weights for your brain. Every time you do that, you're commanding your brain cells to build new footpaths. The more you use them, those paths turn into paved roads and eventually into superhighways. This is why when a 70-year-old decides to learn the piano, their brain physically changes. The connections between their neurons become denser and stronger. So this is no longer about preventing damage, it's about building new strength.